Hello and welcome everyone. So in the last video we talked about Nest.js CLI, okay, and we created a base application and we were able to run it. Okay, in this video we will talk about adding NodeMore and TSLint for our project and make it like a production level application where we are able to lint the code, we are able to write test cases, we are able to run the test cases and validate the code, okay. So for that, what you need to do is you just need to create a nodemon.json file. You just need to install npm install --- save nodemon. Okay. So what nodemon is giving? Nodemon is just going to help you in debugging, and it has its own watcher. So whenever you do npm run debug, so on the debug I'm running nodemon, and nodemon will look into nodemon.json file. Here it is, it will check what it need to compile and run. Okay, so I'm using TSNode register. TSNode is a module which will help me to compile the TypeScript code on the fly and will run my server. Okay, src main.ts. So when I do npm run, debug, so what it will do is it will just look at the nodemon.json file. It is executing this command, right? And it will start our application. Okay, what other things I have added is tslint.json file. It is used for linting the code, so you can define your own tslint rules. Currently, I'm extending the tslint recommended. So there are some basic tslint rules I'm extending. If you wanted to add your own, then you can just override and add your configuration. Like quotation marks should be single, and it is true. Member access is false. Trailing comma should be false. So true, false. And in the package.json, I did some changes that, okay, for npm run start, I will use the tsnode only. And I'm using this tsnode path register to just start the application on the fly. For npm run start dev, it's same as the npm run debug. Okay, so this is how I'm running the project. And you can also check npm run lint. So lint is actually running this, it is looking at the tsconfig.json, and we already have a tslint file. And you can also run tslint fix. What it will do is, if there are any tslint errors which can be automatically fixed, it will apply those fixes here. Okay, so now we have a base application running, and I already pushed this code to the repository. I will share the repository in the description. Okay, coming back to our APIs. So we have created our basic user controller. Okay, let's try to run that. Npm run start, and we can see what we are getting. If I do curl, so here my application is running, and it is running on the port 3000. So I can just use hello command, right? I got it. So I have another is like user route. So I'm just hitting HTTP GET request and I'm able to get the response. Okay, now what we will do is we'll create a module and we will try to see what is the role of service, what is the role of controller, and how we are able to create these routes. Okay, HTTP GET, HTTP POST. Okay, similarly HTTP PUT, HTTP DELETE, all these routes we can create in our application. So what we will do, we'll create some, we don't have a database now. So what we will do is, we can have a small data service, like in the user service, we can have a small data service, which will maintain the data. Which will maintain the data for us. So here you can call it is user service. And here we can say get user. Okay, we can have the different methods, add user, and it will return. We can have an interface also here because it's a TypeScript, and we'll have a user.ts file. So we have to create an interface. So I will be exporting this interface, and what all I have in this interface is the email, which is of type string. Okay, these two properties I have, and this user service, this user will be able to return the user which I'm creating. So this is how we return add user. So what we will do is we can have a global user object. Users of type user array. Okay, now what we will do is when you are going to add user, I will just here we are passing the user object. User is of type user. We are getting it. So what we will do is this dot users dot push. We will just add a new user which we just got, and we will just return this user. Right. Similarly, add user, delete, get users will do nothing but it will just return the set of users we have. This dot users, and what it is returning, the user array. So return type will be based on that only. Okay. Similarly, you can have some service method which is like delete user, update user. So for delete user, you can have some kind of an index. You can say, okay, email should be fine. So if you wanted to delete a user, you will be passing, okay, I wanted to pass email for a user which I wanted to delete, and I will be returning the remaining users. Okay, so what I will do is I will just run the filter remaining users, and this dot users dot filter you can do. And here what I will say that I dot email should not be equal to the email which you are passing. I will get the filtered list of users. Remaining users, and you just need to override this dot users equal to. I mean, there are many ways, either you splice it or do something. Okay, this is how we created a service methods. Now in this user controller, get user. So what we need to do, we need to do the dependency injection. This is called dependency injection because data will be held by our services. So constructor, here I can just inject this service, private read only, and user service. I'm able to import that. Okay, now for get users, let's call it as a get users. What I need to do is I need to call this service get user service dot get user. It should be get users because there are many users we are getting. Let's call it as a get users. There can be one another is get user, which is going to return a single user which will take email as an argument. So for this, we will be just returning an object, user object, and what we will do is we'll just do a filter where i.email equal to the email which you supplied. If we get this, then I will just return the zeroth object. I mean, just get it, assign it to some variable, and then just return the zeroth index. It is returning as an object. In the user controller, now get users is returning the user array. I just need to import this from the interface. Get users. Okay, let me check why it is complaining. The function we declared is neither void or must return. Okay, yeah, sorry, I missed the return statement. Get users, now you can just save it. But before that, now in this user module we have introduced a user service, so we have to inject it also. We have to add it in the user module in the providers, otherwise dependency injection will not happen. We have added user service, user controller. User controller, we have done the dependency injection. Now we can just save it, and we are not running it in the Node mode. npm run, you can say debug. Okay, so this is how we are actually able to inject the service inside a controller. Similarly, we can have some kind of a constant list of data. It's empty. You can keep adding the new set of users. For new set of users, it's a get. It can be a post. Okay, here you'll be just getting some data. Okay, so we'll talk about how to write different methods. Get is plain and simple. You are not getting any data in the request body. But what happens when you are getting data in the request body, or you are getting the request data in the request parameter, query parameter? So here you have to use these body tags. Okay, you can say user is of type user here, and you just need to import it. Okay, this is of type capital user, and what you are doing is here you will be adding it. So this dot user service dot add user, and just pass this user object down there, and it should return a user object. This is fine. Similarly, we can have another delete method, right? So it will be a delete user, and in this email, in this, what we will do is we have to pass request parameter. So this is how we will pass it, email, and here instead of body we'll be using param. Okay, here you can say email, and this email is of type string, and just pass this delete user, and just pass this email, and what this delete user is returning. Now we should return simple object, or you can say nothing. For now, let's return the list of remaining users. That is fine. We'll just change it later. So it is returning an array of remaining users. We have to import the delete. Similarly, you can have a put delete. You can put a forward slash also if you want. So this will be like, this will get an API endpoint, something like this. HTTP get forward slash user. We can just change this to users for better. REST API's standards, and this will be HTTP post users. Okay, this API will be a little different. It will be delete. So HTTP delete it will be, and users forward slash email. Something like this. We will be triggering them, right? Okay, so this is about basic introduction about how we creating service, how we are creating controllers, how the services are getting injected inside a controller. Okay, so we will look more on these. We will extend this example, and we will introduce more Nest.js building blocks, which are filters, pipes, interceptors, middlewares, and all.